They speak.
Huh?
They speak.
Yeah. Same drink.
But you know what I'm glad to see you doing? You're passing on to the next generation.
That's the truth.
You know, one of the things I regret the most about growing up here at the Toll, right? You know my grandfather Raymond.
Yes, I know.
When you're sick, if he hear you coughing or something, he go and he pick a bush.
Yep.
And he tell you, put your grandma put this in water for you. But he never show you the damn bush.
I'm going to my jacket, seize it up nice, lemon it up, and I'm going to fry it and stew it down with the onion, tomato paste, pepper and everything, and then cook some rice on the side.
Hey, because put that in that white cool off, make an ice in it. Put it in there for me.
So, you know, you got to make sure that all the scales are off. My grandmother will ring your ear.
You know, listen, she give you a fish to clean, right? And she cooked the fish. And the skills of the fish, which you went.
She weighing in at $120 for this one fish. Tell him give me $50 and it's theirs. Now, this one you come up by the eye, that are the easiest way to find the skin. So when you pull that is skin coming. You want to use your thumb to push, keeping the white part on the fillet. So you see how I pushing all that, pushing it down, but you want to bring it to the beginning of the stomach. And once you reach this belly and you free the belly, you're home free. Now you grab the head of the fish and you just pull, making sure no flesh goes on the fillet, and that comes off in one pull. Now to get that fillet, we hold up and we just stay as close to the bone as possible, and we just walk that knife all the way down. There you go. But you see, you want no meat on this bone, not at all.
Keep the bill in there.
Come in. I know. Where you at?
You got your face back? I said, you don't know me, no. Okay. But I got back by your mother, no.
She gets that to me. So, season it. Let's season it up and then put your onion, your pepper, garlic, everything in it.
Mm-hmm.
A little butter, and you can wrap it in the foil and either put it in your oven or.
Yeah.
It'll be easier. Yeah. It'll be cool. Nice. Bring a piece of stick.
Yeah. Raising the Tobagos, we growing like fresh tomatoes. Them boys on fire, too fuego. We pass it round, hot potato. Everything is nuevo. I'm with my sweetie like Quavo. Need my cheese, need that queso. Need my bread, need that bankroll. Wake up, yes, Lord, I'm thankful. Another day on my schedule. Steady blocking the devil. I tell a hater, God bless you. Cherish moments that special. You gotta keep the memento. If you love me, then I love you. And I could never forget you.
Some memories don't fade. Sometimes you miss the old days, but nothing changed, lest you change what's around you. How you think, how you live, how you speak, how you walk, how you blink, how you talk, how you teach, how you reach, let it sink.
What's your purpose, what's your passion,
through the pain, what's your plan?
Is it play, on a plane, how to play, I'm just playing. What's your purpose, what's your passion,
through the pain, what's your plan?
Is it play, on a plane, how to play, I'm just playing.
I beat by Joby, feel like Obi-Wan Kenobi, cause I'm a star and they can't hold me like I'm Kobe in the fourth. Yeah, nothing is ever forced, we headed straight to the source. No middleman, little man, let me show you if you is lost. It's a couple college courses, but I ain't finished that shit. Been chasing dreams since 17, so yeah, I've been on my shit. Yeah, we loaded up the vault and had to empty the clip. Remember days we wasn't paid and had to roll up the clips. Now the urge be extra strong and they come in a zip. People say we taking long, but we ain't rushing with shit. Put the plans in God's hands and he gon' bless us with riches. I ain't tripping over shit because I'm watching my step. Putting money on the phone, Kadab and calling collect. All in respect, I can't lie, I'm just here for a check. Just to build my family out and to buy your family house. A lot of people only talking, put your money where your mouth is.
Some memories don't fade, sometimes you miss the old days. But nothing changed, lest you change what's around you. How you think, how you live, how you speak, how you walk, how you blink, how you talk, how you teach, how you reach, let it sink.
What's your purpose, what's your passion,
do the pain,
what's your plan, is it plain?
You can't teach Carl nothing because he thinks he knows it fucking all.
No! Did I jump the shit?
That would never do.
Yeah, never did it.
You want to do what you know now?
I got Google that fuck.
Wow.
You think
Google everything?
Maybe.
You think everything, but Google it, you'll see what time it is.
I forgot where my phone is. Let me end this right now.
Okay.
Alright, Carl, Google have something for you.
What is it?
It say eagle rays can be seen jumping out of the water but never witnessed it before.
Right.
At least not close. Scientists speculate, so this is not a fact, okay? Because they may see like us. So, scientists speculate that leaping rays may be females trying to avoid unwanted attention from males.
That's not true.
Or may do it to shake off parasites or remoraids. These may also perform noisy belly flops and stuff, but I see when an eagle ray jump, now I go behind of it, there is shit behind.
Yes, so, I see that too. Hey, where is the free dive, right?
You know what?
With all these boys, I used to go down in cave, 60, 70 feet deep. And I tell them, man, when I down there, I gone in a cave. When I lock my foot like this, I come down and haul me out. Because I tell them I don't got what I want, like a lobster or something hold on, right? So I tell them, I'm gonna lock my foot like this, I come and haul. You know how long I down there before I could come down there? That's what I used to do. I tell you. You know why they call me bully? Me no bad man, you know. Because when I go out there, I shoot a lot of flatfish, right? They might come there like me. They call me flatfish bully. Flatfish bully, not never me bully. Like, I'm a fucking bad man. Me no bad man. I just loving, generous person. <horse. laughs> That's who I is.
You're gonna know what I mean.
So you used to hold your bed like that, man?
Babe, boy, the man, 60, 70 feet, I don't have them, I come down and pull me out, and go back up.
Man, I could do that and see.
Man, I tell you.
You ever passed out?
Huh?
You ever passed out?
Never one day.
No?
Never one day pass out. You see, Alec, Andrew, right? I chained my son up to dive. One day we were diving the dog. Of the dog, we were in about, I say we were about 80 to 90 feet of water, right? But the current was strong. So Andrew was there, you know, I watching him, I'm his father, and I protect all my kids there. I watched Andrew turn around shooting all kind of fish, right? I said, this man, he don't get a problem, you know. I said, Andrew don't get a problem, you know. At this depth, this current, what he's doing is no good. All of a sudden, right, I feel it, I watched him at the time, I feel it grab me, right? He get amazed. You got what you're doing, get amazed. And I know he get amazed, he know where up or down was. Now go there, I know it will happen. When you get amazed, I decide, okay, I hold it, and now we can come up. We'll come up slowly, act everything good, tell me. You know what I mean? So we keep coming to the surface. And then I tell him exactly what went wrong. I said, listen, you see everything down there, all kind of fish, the current was strong, you were moving too much in that current and that depth. I said, you had to get amazed, something had to happen to you. And I said, a good thing I was there, never do it again. You must be relaxed. You can't be rushing nothing. You gotta be relaxed. That depth, the current, you gotta be relaxed.
So what he was doing? Just hustling, shooting fish?
Hustling, shooting fish and things. He got carried away. Because so many things were there, he gets carried away. And I watching him all the time. I know it's gonna have something happen. I actually never get attacked by a shark, no. But I was on close contact with them, but they weren't for me. What a shark was doing, right? And I shoot fish, right?
Mm-hmm.
I shoot fish. And then when I shoot the fish, the shark stuck in me, but water dirty. So I didn't know it was there. And when I shoot the fish, because at the time I didn't have the card on my spear.
Mm-hmm.
So I take my spear, I put in the gun, I feel like a push back.
Yeah.
And the shark will come straight, take the spear out of my hand, eat the fish out of the spear.
Damn.
But I never had no attack by no shark. I had to get rid of them at a certain time. But they wasn't like attacking, but they were coming close.
Yeah,
and
yeah.
They were like, too many of them.
So what do? You throw the bag or you
no,
shoot
no,
the
no.
Shark,
what I do, right, is like, I put a shot on the biggest one.
Uh-huh.
And then when the biggest one shut off, I was like, God, never see him again.
Yeah, that makes sense.
Yeah. But it ain't to kill. It's just to make sure you know, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
To go and then
yeah.
Everybody gone.
In a part of the shark, you could just choke him in.
You could choke, but they sometimes don't come that close to choke them. They come close, but you can't choke them. No. I want to tell you this, I tell this one. I would dive in back a French monkey. Now they're not white shirt. And I don't think nobody should dive in on white clothes.
Now check him.
And let me tell you something, right?
Oh, really?
The biggest shark,
the biggest shark
ever seen and not know it was there, it was like from me to Zach. Me, Andrew, I put my gun on him, right? I put my gun in and then follow you around. I tell you, I don't know if he went or what, but I get in the water, so I'm not gonna dive in no more white clothes at all. Don't dive nothing white. Shark attracted to a white, anything white. Like white clothes. Trust me, I proved that. Now my diving, I proved that.